Jadi saya tidak mau berdebat karena sudah karena waktu itu perdebatan antara UGM di sebelah kanan saya kita ada 4 orang itu secara live ya dibikin Profesor Ruth lari. Saya nanti kasih videonya. Permisi Pak, nggak bisa jawab pertanyaan-pertanyaan simpel. Setengah jam kemudian wakilnya Dr. Warsito lari. Jadi sejam berikutnya kita diskusi di antara kita sendiri. Jadi udah terbukti. Jadi kita udah duel, Pak. Udah duel, ya. Jadi simple aja. Ya. Jadi kalau secara sains ya kita sudah membuktikan secara terbuka ya bahwa mereka nggak bisa jawab. Kemudian mereka melaporkan kepada menteri bahwa mereka nggak melaporkan bahwa mereka itu kalah dalam debat. Mereka mengatakan bahwa kita ini penganut teori konspirasi. Saya sampaikan, Pak, itu laporan buahmu bohong. Ini videonya 2 jam mereka lari, saintis-saintis itu. Oleh karena itu, Profesor Ruhut sama Dr. Warsito, di mana kalau dia datang, saya datang, dia selalu menghindar. Ya, selalu menghindar. Jadi perdebatan sains bagi saya sudah selesai.
And there is no enough explanation from this. Even the technology, let's say the technology is good, no side effect. But if the people is ignorant about that, I think it's a matter of to convey the safety of this. In that sense, then the question from Chok become relevant. Ibu Adi, maybe you can help us. If there's any human impact, health impact, if it is the mosquito bite a human being, Bu, maybe you can educate a little bit.
Maybe Pak Warsito has.
Pak Warsito.
Pak Warsito, please.
Yeah, I think it's thank you very much for the, we tested as well for the impact of the World Bank on the human health. So yeah. Because in Yogyakarta, the mosquito actually feeded by human. And then on the early release when we did
oh,
it.
Oh yeah, yeah, on the yeah. safety, yeah. You mean yeah, on the safety then, of World Bank yeah, for yeah. human. Yeah.
And we watch correct voluntary from the community, we withdraw the blood. And when you tested the antibody, that probably to respond the World Bank, yeah, and then totally from the hundreds of sample that we take it from the community, and then also take it from the human that is like for me actually, I feed it mosquito from 2012. And then on the research, they take it my blood and then tested the antibody. And then so far, there is no antibody that suspected as the response of the that World Bank. Yeah, that is already published as well. And then I already put on the link. In terms of the World Bank, actually, as the Prof. Uwud mentioned, that there are two approach. One approach is actually for the population replacement. And the second approach is actually in the population reduction. So what French talk is about, mostly is about what you call that population reduction. So they release the male because in the male, there is the Wolbachia causes the cytoplasmic incompatibility where male with a Wolbachia when mating with a female without Wolbachia, that the eggs is actually fertile, what you call that sterile. So they cannot group become the larvae. So and that's why this technology actually use it in Singapore and some area in other country. So they release the male, expected that the male with Wolbachia will mating with a female without Wolbachia, and then the population will be drop. So we expected that population drop will cause the drop of the case as well. But in Yogyakarta, under the WMP approach, we not concerned about the population. We concerned about the capacity of the Wolbachia to block the dengue virus inside of the body of the mosquito. So we released the male and female Wolbachia actually hereditated to the generation to the generation. So with one time of release about 6 months, and then Wolbachia frequency will increase, and in the same level, they will maintain by themselves to increase by themselves. So we talk about the capacity of the Wolbachia to block. So we we change the population with previously we thought Wolbachia become the IJCHFT with Wolbachia. So I think we have to be careful to look which one is actually we want to what we're gonna discuss in this. We want to review in this kind of the discussion. I think I agree with Adi Utarani, but and totally in Indonesia with what we done in Yogyakarta and in Bali as well, we release the eggs and conscious male and female because we want to what call it the change, not the change, but the replace of the population that previously without Wolbachia become the population with Wolbachia.
Thank you,
Richard. Can I add few things, yes, Richard?
Sure, Ibadi.
I'm aware of time also.
No, it's okay, bro. The floor is yours. Go ahead.
Yeah.
Bro.
So I'm not staying long in this webinar. Just two things. I hear that perhaps there's a concern, but that there is that there needs to be more information shared to the public, right? Yeah. And when talking about the public, what you specifically mentioned is about Bali.
Yeah.
Now, I would really suggest, Pak, please talk to the people who is doing it in Bali. So Dr. Chok, for example, you're not just talking to the community, but please have a discussion with the implementers in Bali. And perhaps you would like to say, okay, this is already done. And perhaps you could say, this needs to be done more in Bali so that the people will have more information about the technology, and so that what's happening in their lives, they know what's the knowledge, and then how are they going to implement that. So I would really encourage, please talk to the implementers there, rather than, you know, we are trying to understand something, but I saw, you know, also a lot of WhatsApp messages to the public, which is also confusing the public, because then you are sort of assuming that Wolbachia is genetic modification, which is not. So, I mean, that's one suggestion. Second, if you are curious about the science, which, I mean, this is what the scientists do, you know, we communicate and we talk to each other, we explain. Then that is something that we often do also. Pak Warsito also speaks in a lot of discussion, a lot of webinars, but let's keep it in that way. You know, we could provide for you, we could even present what's the evidence with all the questions that you have. But I'm saying is that there are two things here. One, yes, maybe there's a need for the community in Bali to know more about this technology. So please talk to the implementers. And then secondly, if you want to know about the scientists, there's also a scientist behind this in Yogyakarta. If this is related to what we did in Yogyakarta, we are very happy to share. Also the papers, perhaps in some other discussion where we could present the evidence to you if you want to know. But the risk analysis, I can give the contact person, because this is done by IPB, Pak Richard.
Yeah,
very good. Prof. Dami. So there we can have a really scientific discussion and not much based on assumptions and those things. So that's what I'm going to say. And thank you for having this, Pak Richard. And I cannot stay long, but I'm sorry.
So, it's okay, Bu. But yeah. You summarize very well, Bu.
Yeah, yeah.
Very well.
Thank you, Pak and Ibu.
So the situation is like this. We have to consider Bali is a very special place in Indonesia, because there are a lot of foreigners here, and this can create panics among them. And if this creates panics, and people in Bali will suffer, as we know that the income of the people is most from tourism. And you can imagine if they release this, the implementer release this in November, there will be a drop of tourism. I just think that we have to think over about this to release this in Bali, not because we are doubt about the good faith of the UGM and government Indonesia. Not we don't doubt about the good faith of that, but if it is good, it's okay. But we have to really consider all aspects, the budaya, the culture, and so on. And if one fire is released about panic, nobody will come to Bali. And if you don't come to Bali, the effect will be change effect. Even you have a good fit, and then will come to the government, to UGM, to all scientists here. Dr. Pacok, your comments before I give to Pak Warsito. Thank you, Ibu Adi Utarini. Very nice of you.
Sorry, Richard, I have to go.
Thank you very much.
No, any information, just text me, just email me. And I have a link to WMP as well. To the WMP, I think it's better to talk to them as well. Thank you very much. Yeah, happy to have a touch with you all.
Take care, Pak.
Thank you very much.
Pak Asik masih ada ya, Pak Asik Surya. Okay. Marin, you have any comments if you like?
Ya, yeah, Pak. Tinggal ini Pak.
Ya Pak Asik, gimana?
Ya. Thank you so much Pak. I think we are stuck on what we have already talked with you, Pak Warsito and also with the Professor Uut. I think the program is just based on the data. But I know we realize that some approach maybe ya, usually like in Bali something like that. But I think it's not just only about for the technology, I think, but I think it's just only for how we are approaching for the community. I think this is really appreciate for this the issue, Pak. But of course, we are cannot developing many issue presumption and some assumption something like that. But I think we are cannot talk for long time. That's on. Yeah, of course, I know for the issue, but this issue the political will. Political issue, maybe that like the conspiration, whatever, something like that. But for the program, me as the implementer, especially because we are see from the Professor Wu, Professor Sito, and others that this really is approved for the program, and then we are trying to put it, and of course, we are. Applying for the program in local government, and then after that we are trying to, of course, like the how we are dealing with the community acceptance, something like that. Of course, there are somebody that still not really understand, and maybe something like that. But of course, this is we hope that this is our assignment together for how
I understand the message, but understand.
Yeah, Pak. I think that's all, Pak, for the government. But if we are talking a lot about something like that, but I think we are cannot finish because we have already take long time. You in your proposition for 10 and 30, right? Sorry.
Yes, yes. I understand that your research already finished, right? Your finish is done.
Yeah,
right?
Yeah.
And
yeah,
now it's about the implementation, no? Yeah. We talk about course, the implementation, all the people will accept of that from the security. Yeah. So we see from all of aspects. Marin, Marin. Pak Cok.
Yeah. Thank you. Community so leader. I think we are.
Yeah, course, thank you, Pak Asik. Yeah, keep in touch.
Thank you, Pak. Bye, Pak.
Cok, you have any thing to say as a community leader?
Pak Johannes Ankawijaya has put his hand up several times. I'm not sure if he wants to say something important.
So. No, later, with him later. I know him very well.
All right. Yeah.
He's a biologist.
Yeah, you know, I can't talk as a community leader, really. I mean, I'll just talk as rakyat kecil aja, ya.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm a I'm a taxpayer.
Okay.
Maybe maybe we can if they're very convinced about the safety of this. I think there's a bigger mosquito and dengue fever problem in Jakarta, and maybe the maybe we little Balinese would be happy if they could do the trial first in the Depe area.
Yeah,
di Kementerian Kesehatan dilepaskan dulu di sana. Yeah. If it's really, 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 really watertight and it's very much for the safety of us all, it should be of benefit to that. Maybe the people who and again, you know, I don't know enough. We also don't know who are the implementers. We would also probably like to know who is actually behind the funding, and so on and so forth. And again, with all due respect to people who dedicate their lives to the benefit, you know, the healing and the health of others. And I believe a lot of scientists have that motivation. But yeah, we would probably be more comfortable if that was the case for.